to write out there, we're gonna watching and we're getting married, and maybe you get some advice to give them about anything during the wedding planning process. So what can you tell them?
My advice really is that everything cannot go perfect, so don't stress about it. The important thing is you're gonna walk down the aisle and you're gonna marry the person that you love, and all that little stuff needs to just go away.
When you're trying to, you know, find your vendor, so can you kind of tell them how did you find most of your vendor, like me and Jamie and stuff like that?
I didn't know where to look. I ended up on Instagram looking at hashtags, and I found you under a hashtag, under, I think it was SoCal Photographer.
Yes.
And it was a picture of a couple. They were doing a dip next to a lake with a kiss, and there was a sunbeam coming out from behind him. And I ran to him and I was like, I found our photographer. Because it was exactly that picture right there. I was like, look what she did with the sun. That's our photographer right there. That was, and then I looked up your website. I called you the next morning at work, and that was it.
What can you tell them? Like, do you think you need to tell your bride, like, they have to meet in person, or just, you know, hire over the internet?
It depends. I mean, some brides go into it not knowing what they want. There's a lot of different types of photography out there. There's very soft pastel colors, real glowy. Then you have bold, vibrant colors. You have magical nighttime skies. You have beautiful sunsets. And you just have to figure out, when you look at the pictures, can you see yourself in
yes.
that setting? I knew what I wanted. I wanted bold, vibrant colors because we were having a fall wedding. I knew I wanted the deep colors. I knew I wanted the sunset, and I knew that there might be some rain that day, so I needed somebody who could work with clouds. Mm-hmm. And that's exactly what I got.
So about, you know, you're talking about all these beautiful different styles, and you're right, everybody's got to find what they love, but I know for a fact, like, because I heard that a lot, it's not just about the photography, it's also the services behind, also the knowledge, the experience you receive from your vendors. So is this something they need to pay attention to
yes.
from your point of view?
That's what was important about meeting you. Well, I knew that once I met you, on top of loving your photography, if you understood my vision,
yes.
I'd get that right away from
yes.
you. And we did. Right away we both left that first meeting, and we loved you and we loved your husband, and we were completely comfortable. We knew that you understood what we were looking for. You recommended Jamie to us. You even explained.
You were a business fan too, so.
Yeah. And I mean, and you explained how the photographer and the DJ worked together to run the ceremony, which I never knew. That wasn't something that I knew, and you gave me the knowledge about that, and I learned a lot that night.
Things you did not even realize, like when we took your picture, we were like literally on the roads mm-hmm. next door, you know, two cars and that road, we were blocking the entire road.
Yeah.
And you can see that picture right here. And I mean, we took in our time, we were a little bit, you know, over the time, and you know, you didn't even realize it, but your guests were so well taken care of, mm-hmm. you know, on the other side, because Jamie knew what I was doing. And you know, you weren't taking care of completely, so it was pretty fun.
They did. I got some feedback from the guests because I knew that we were out there a little bit longer than
yeah.
we were supposed to, but the pictures were very important. And when I came back to the guests to ask them, you know, like, did we take too long? Were you guys hungry? Everybody said no. The DJ kept everybody informed. The appetizers were still being tossed around. And she was very interactive with everybody.
That's important.
And they brought up the llama. So,
and the llama. Yeah, that was a lot of fun. So from you, you know, Jonathan, you're a groom. So, you know, sometimes groom tends to take a step back in the wedding process and sometimes feel like more like a passenger, more like a driver. So how was your experience from a groom point of view through the entire process? What's stick out?
Well, I was very lucky because Melissa knew exactly what she wanted, and I, for the most part, could stay out of the way and just be available for feedback when it was needed. And when that was asked, I was happy to give it.
Aww, you're so sweet. I still want to keep on taking pictures of the two of you. Like, you're just too cute. Anyway, so I remember when you came into our consultation the first time, so you were very happy with the picture, but then you get so much information about the planning process, how to organize things, about how to get the timeline done. How does it make you feel? Like you felt overwhelmed or more comfortable? Was it a plus to you?
I was overwhelmed a lot of the time because I felt like, because you have so many vendors and everybody needs you to make decisions and everybody seems to want those decisions and at the same time. You know, and when you're working full time, you spend most of your day commuting, being able to make those phone calls and send those emails, it gets really difficult. And, you know, just taking the time to decide, or even better than that, not just deciding, but you gave some recommendations that I needed to pass on to the other vendors.
Yeah.
And, you know, making sure to communicate with everybody, it does get very overwhelming.
It's what we're trying to do, like to give you good advice, is to make sure everything goes flawless, because
right.
I see so many brides, they don't know how to interact with everybody. They do not understand, like especially if you do not have a wedding coordinator, like a personal wedding coordinator, mm-hmm. not just someone from the venue, but like right. someone who take care of everything, like, then the floor, the floor is the DJ, the photographer, the videographer, you know, all these vendors need to interlock into a specific moment to work well together.
Right.
So, and we're trying to give you all these guidelines.
Right.
Also, I know you were completely in love with the fact we could customize the albums. So tell us about how was the process with the albums and the guest book.
Love the album. I was worried that I might have been bothering you after a while because I wanted to tweak so many things here and there. And I told him, I was like, but I got to look at this for the rest of my life.
This is what we do.
So, but in the end, it was beautiful. It was gorgeous. Everything was just as we asked for it to be and everything that we hoped it would be. The two of them are sitting in our living room right now and everybody wants to look at them and I tell them, don't touch. Don't touch.
Just you can look, but that's
it. You can look, but don't touch.
And I remember, like, you were having so much fun to take the picture. Like, you were not, you know, some couples sometimes they run into a situation, they want to stop, they don't want to take a picture, but with you, it's like, oh, but I'm sorry, they keep on going.
Mm-hmm. You know, Jamie had a lot of information in the beginning. I really didn't understand. I thought that I was going to be in full control of the timeline, you know, and that was something I was stressing about. I was on paper and pencil every single day trying to figure out how much time we need for each thing. And then she jumped in and she took over. And I didn't have to worry about much at all. The two of you together.
Yeah, together. We did it for you.
The entire itinerary and I didn't have to worry about a thing. It worked flawlessly.
It's what we're trying to do, templates for everybody. So, and there's so many scenarios people don't realize. It's like a wedding was in one location. It's not going to have the same itinerary to a wedding who's, you know, you get ready in your hotel, you go to a church, then the party, then the reception, you know, mm-hmm. it's like that is get very long and that need to be thought out. Even a wedding in one venue, it's like one photographer, is it two photographers? It's not the same.
Mm-hmm.
So when you have vendors who understand, I think, the concept of the itinerary, how important it is to put it together, to just make your day smoother. You, what happens is that when you know it's taken care of, you relax.
Mm-hmm.
And when you relax, you enjoy the day.
And we did.
Because I always say, it's better if you stress a few days beforehand, mm-hmm. you get all over that, but then on your wedding day, you're not stressed out.
Right.
But if you go to your wedding day and you're stressing out because you have no idea what to do and nobody's telling you what to do, you're going to be like, why am I here, you know?
Well, I can say the stress was at an ultimate low. I can say that we sat back, we enjoyed the wedding, we remember the wedding, we got to eat our food, we got to talk to our guests, and I hear a lot of brides and grooms who say that they don't get to do those things. So that I'm really grateful for, because I felt like I got to enjoy this wedding that we spent a year planning.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Thank you for coming. I really appreciate it. That was absolutely awesome. And if you have something to tell my bride about my services, go ahead. Tell them why they should hire me.
If you want the best, then this is the best.
Oh.
I mean, there's no doubt about it. This is the best. She will get the job done, just like she promised.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Melissa. Thank you, Jonathan. Thank you for coming. I love you. And I hope we're going to keep on taking this beautiful picture for families. And, you know, I know you already have a daughter. So
we're going to take two years.
And, you know, graduation and stuff like that. So you know where to find me. And I'm happy that you're happy. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, YouTuber. Thank you for watching. Hope you sell. Bye.